Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll be explaining you a revised version of Compare Data template. In this template, now you can see there is a individual sheets for added, removed and changed data. So in the previous version of the sheet, we could able to compare data and paste the differences in this variance sheet like this. So this is old data, new data and variance. So with the click of a button, we could able to see the change, remove and added data. Now what we want to see all this data separately in individual sheets. So for example, added data, you want to see in a separate sheet. You want to see the changed data in a separate sheet. And similarly, you want to see removed data records in a separate sheet. So I have created the same, and which is also is done with the help of a VBA macro. So that means it's quickly done with this one click. So I'll just show you example. I will click this button which says copy data to three sheets. So it's going to copy data to three sheets, and I'll explain you the code in detail in just a moment. So I'll just click this. It will ask whether you really want to do this. It's a warning message. I said yes. If you see, the data has been copied. So this is a really nice way to see your data separately and analyze it separately. Now let's go to the back end of this workbook in the VBA module. So this is the module which is add, remove and change sheet. So let's start with this, how the code for add sheet works. So this particular sheet, how it is working. So it starts with the range, of course, and it selects our variance sheet, which is nothing but Hoja 3 as per the name of the sheet, as you know. This one, which is nothing but this variance sheet, this sheet. So it selects that, and then it goes to entire sheet selection to make sure we are selecting the complete range. And we are focusing currently in this column A to Y because we want to see what are the values in column A. So here we are trying to select add name, right? So the word add, wherever it is there, it's going to check that. It's going to select. If the word add matches, it's going to select entire row, right? And then it goes to the sheet called added, which is nothing but this added data sheet, which again I have given a code, a sheet name like this, as you can see here. And it selects second row and copies the entire data set. So basically, the macro will check here this entire column. And then for the added, it will select the word added like this. All the rows, all the records for the word add, and then it copies that particular data, comes to this sheet and selects row 2 and paste it here. Similarly, it selects anything which is remove tag here in column A, selects the data set, but here we have only one data, one row, so it will select this row, comes to the remove sheet here and selects the row 2 and copies the data like this, entire row. And similarly for change. So this is the code you can go through. After copying, I have added some formatting code as well. So it selects, for example, in this data set, it will come along with this formatting, green background and bold white color fonts. It will come with the same, but I don't want to see that. So I'm going to remove those. So for that, I'm selecting this sheet. And I'm selecting a very large range to just ensure that all the cells are covered. And then I'll be selecting interior color. I'll be removing that. I will undo the font, which is anything to a black. And then I will also undo the bold. And then again, select A2. I will do same for all these three sheets. Now I want to do all this in one step. So how do I do that? So for that, I have created another macro at the start of this module, which is called copy to three sheets, which is the same here. So basically I'm clearing everything. So before I try to copy it, I make sure that all the data is clear, right? Because otherwise it will copy data above it, above the same data, which will be completely wrong and your analysis will be wrong. So before we try to copy them, we have to remove the existing data from this sheet. So for that, there is a VBA code at the bottom. This is the code, clear contents three sheets. So I'm selecting individual sheets, selecting a row A2 to K2, select a very big range to make sure that we are covering everything. And we are selecting tilde down, Excel down, and clearing contents, formats, everything. That is the code to remove data. First of all, I'm removing the data with a warning. So actually this warning code will be applied first. which you can see here, it is just here. And then if I say yes, it will remove the data. Then it will run this macro for add, for remove, and for change. It will go to our main variance sheet and selects cell A2. So this is what a new version of this Compare Data Workbook is going to work. And if you are interested to buy this, you can find the link in the description below. And any user who has already bought this particular workbook, the earlier version, will get some discount. So reach out to me on my email and I'll give you some discount if you are interested in buying the second version. So many of you might be facing an error while working with the worksheet, especially with the main code. When you press this particular Compare Data sheet, instead of getting a result, you might get object error. The reason for that is if you are comparing two data set like this and the existing records, so suppose in this particular data set, old data, we have this name, right? This name, Mr. Morris. And suppose I go to new data, he's there also. But if I try to delete it, that entire row, if I come here, I clear the data and I press this button, see what happens. You'll get an error. So the code tries to compare a row which doesn't exist anymore because you deleted it. So that's the way the entire code is so complex and designed in such a way that you have to be careful that you don't delete any of the rows, especially the rows which has existing data for comparison. Instead of deleting the data, you can do one thing. You can select that particular data set in the new if you want to remove it and clear content and try to make sure that you don't have any spaces like this. I just did it to show you that instead of deleting any data set, especially when you're comparing the same data, don't delete it, try to clear content like this. So if you keep this in mind, you will avoid object runtime fail error and your analysis will work just fine. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions, please let me know. And link for buying this workbook, the new version, is also available in the description below. Thank you very much for watching.